I got my hands on the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra almost 9 months ago, and during this time this device has been an amazing companion to me. Till recently it was the best device I ever had, and I think the S21 Ultra is still the best Android phone right now. In this video I'm going to give you my honest opinion about my experience with this amazing device. This is my Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra long-term review. When it comes to the build quality, the S21 Ultra still looks and feels incredible. It is made of glass in front and back with an aluminum frame. For the most part I use this device in a case, that's why it doesn't have scratches at all. Every time I remove the case, however, I am always amazed by the build quality of it. Even when I use it without a case I am very confident, because it has the latest and greatest Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. The matte black color is just stunning to look at, and it feels amazing in the hand too. It is, however, a thick and heavy device, so people who are used with lighter phones might feel uncomfortable. On the other hand, I just love the build quality of this device. One of the best things about the S21 Ultra is the gorgeous 6.8-inch dynamic AMOLED display. The display on this device is one of the best in the market. It is very sharp and it has a 120Hz refresh rate. Because of this feature, everything I do on this device feels very smooth to me. It is one of the brightest displays on the market. I never had any troubles on viewing content, even in direct sunlight. Watching HDR content in this device is just a joy. This incredible brightness is, however, only reached in auto mode. So when you are inside it won't become as bright as the iPhone 13 for example. This is however just a small complaint I have. Other than that the display is amazing. My S21 Ultra runs perfectly Android 11 with One UI 3. During my usage I never had any lags with the software. I am however so hyped for One UI 4. Especially since it seems to have a material design. When it comes to the performance, the S21 Ultra is still a beast. It can easily handle everyday tasks and even heavy games open very fast. My S21 Ultra is a global unit, so it is powered by the Exynos 2100. And even though it can run everything easily, it just can't match the A15 Bionic found on the iPhone 13 series. RAM management is also amazing because it has 12GB. The base storage, however, is 128GB, and it is plenty enough for most of the people. I do, however, miss the SD card slot. The cameras of the Galaxy S21 Ultra have always been reliable to me in every situation. The main 108MP camera did always produce sharp, bright and vibrant images. The ultra-wide camera, I think, is still the best in the market. Even better than the ultra-wide of the 13 Pro. The 3x zoom telephoto camera, even though good, it isn't the best out there. And for sure it can't be compared with the 3x zoom found on the 13 Pro. I do however love the 10x zoom camera of the S21 Ultra. During my usage I have found many use cases for this particular lens. The front camera is very good too. Pictures taken with it are very sharp and the dynamic range is excellent. When it comes to low light, every camera of the S21 Ultra supports night mode, and the results from the main and ultra-wide cameras are always bright and very detailed. The telephoto cameras, on the other hand, are only activated when there is a lot of light, and the results aren't that great. The night mode on the front camera, however, is one of the best. The S21 Ultra shines even at video recording. Besides the ultra-wide camera, all other lenses have OIS. So videos always come sharp and steady. 8K video recording is still far from perfect, so I never use it. But when it comes to 4K videos, the S21 Ultra is just unmatched by the Android competition. On the other hand, I think Samsung has still a lot of work to do if it wants to catch Apple for video recording. I do, however, love the camera system of the S21 Ultra, and I couldn't ask for more. I would like to show you some samples I've taken recently with the S21 Ultra. Audio quality of the S21 Ultra is pretty good too. It has a pair of stereo speakers and they are loud and clear. Actually, the speakers of the S21 Ultra are some of the best in the industry. The S21 Ultra misses the headphone jack. And usually I wouldn't mind it because most of the review units I own don't have it either. But Samsung used to listen to its consumers. And since my previous daily driver from Samsung, the S10 Plus had this feature, I miss it from time to time. Another great thing about the S21 Ultra is its battery life. I am a heavy user, and it always managed to get me through a day with a single charge. Light users can stretch it maybe for a day and a half. Charging speed, on the other hand, is one of my biggest gripes. A 25-watt charging speed for 2021 is just too slow, and I wish they increase the charging speeds next year. It does also support wireless charging and wireless power share. The main feature for security on the S21 Ultra is the in-display ultrasonic fingerprint scanner. Compared to previous Samsung devices, this scanner is larger and more reliable. It does also have a 2D face scanner. And even though most of the YouTubers say it isn't as secure, it never failed to me. Of course, if you don't want to use them, you have always an option for a PIN or a password. The S21 Ultra is just packed with features. It is the first S device from Samsung to support the S Pen, even though I never use it because it is an accessory, not part of the design. It is also IP68 water and dust resistant. And just like mentioned earlier, it has stereo speakers, wireless charging and wireless power share. So what are my final thoughts about this device after 9 months of using it? Well, the S21 Ultra still remains the best Android phone in the world. The only device better than the S21 Ultra, in my opinion, is the iPhone 13 Pro. In general, I have no major complaints about this phone. The build quality is amazing, the display is incredible, the cameras are reliable, and the battery life is more than enough. If you are planning to buy a new Android device, I think this device should be the Galaxy S21 Ultra. If you already own this phone, I would like to hear your opinion in the comment section below. If you did enjoy this video, a thumbs up would be appreciated. Thank you for watching.